children and welcome back. So children, we are learning about testing and digestion, isn't it? So in the first session you have seen different yummy food items and also how our tongue help us to taste different food items and what are taste buds. So today we'll continue the lesson. Let us see. So today we are going to discuss about digestion. Okay, so here you are going to do one activity, everybody has to do. Okay, now you have to try this. Take a piece of bread or roti or cooked rice, anything whichever is available at home now, you take it. Now what you have to do, put it in your mouth, chew 3 to 4 times and swallow it. What you have to do, you have to chew it for 3 to 4 times only and you have to swallow it. Now, did the taste change as you chew it? Now, whatever food item you ate, did the taste change of that food item? You have to think and you have to write the answers in the comment box. Now, next activity, you have to take another piece of some rice and or roti and chew it to 32 times. Now, what you have to do? Here, you have to chew the food, whatever you have ate, for 32 times. Now, was there any change in the taste after chewing so many times? Now, what was the difference? First was you have chewed the food for 3 to 4 times and the next time you chewed the food for 32 times. Now, you have to recognize or you have to identify the difference between the two tests. In the first activity, was the taste change and in the second was the taste change. Okay, now you have to note down your observations, whatever you felt, you have to note down your observations and write in the comment box. We are waiting for 2 minutes, so quickly you can write the answers in the comment box. Okay, isn't it interesting activity? So everybody is going to do it carefully. Okay, now it is not like that ki you have to take bread, roti, cooked rice. You can take any other food item which is easily available at home and start doing the activity. Okay, now let us see what happens. Now, has anyone at home told you to eat slow and to chew well so that the food digests properly? Why do you think they say this? Okay, in your house your mother, father or any elder person might be telling you all that chew the food slowly, properly. Yes, anyone has told you like that? Why do you think they are telling like this? Yes, so you have to write the answers in the comment box. Okay, now imagine you are eating something hard like a green guava. Yes, have you ate green guava? Yes, so what kind of changes take place in it from the time you bite a piece and put it in your mouth when you to when you swallow it? Okay, so you have to observe or note the changes in the taste of guava from the moment you have bite a piece of guava and start eating till you swallow. Can you see any change in the taste? Can you feel any change in the taste? Okay, now when we eat something or when we see some yummy food, our mouth starts watering. Yes, so the water which comes in our mouth, what it is called? Yes, the water which comes in our mouth, that is called as saliva. Now think, what does this saliva in our mouth do? How does this saliva in our mouth help us? So we will see. Now first, when we eat the food, we put the food in the mouth. So the food enters our mouth, then the teeth which are present in our mouth, they help to chew the food. Now we have learned that there are different types of teeth: biting teeth, chewing, crushing, grinding, excuse me. So there are different types of teeth, 4 types of teeth are there. So these teeth help us to chew the food, they also help us to grind and also bite the food. So which are the 4 types of teeth? Yes, incisors, canines, molars and premolars, isn't it? Now just we were discussing about that watery substance which comes in our mouth, that is saliva. So this saliva mix with the food and makes it soft. Whenever we are eating the food, the saliva mix in the food and the food is made soft so that we can swallow it easily. Okay. So how does the tongue help us? So tongue we have learned in first session. So tongue helps us in four ways. Now tongue helps the food to move from left to right and right to left for proper chewing. When we are eating the food is moved from left to right, right to left. Why it is moved? For the proper chewing. If the food remain in one place, will it be chewed properly? No. So tongue helps to move the food from right to left and left to right so that it is mixed with the saliva also and it is chewed properly. Okay. Now tongue also helps to mix the saliva with the food. It also helps to mix the saliva with the food. Then third use of the tongue is it pushes back the food for swallowing. So when we swallow the food, so after chewing the food we swallow it, isn't it? So the tongue helps to push back the food for swallowing. And the main use is it helps to taste our food, whatever taste it is, spicy, sweet, sour, bitter, whatever it is. So it also helps to taste our food. So these are the four ways how the tongue helps us. Now what do you mean by digestion? Now we are learning digestion here. So do you know what is digestion? Okay. The digestion means the process by which food is broken down into a simpler form so that it can be easily taken in or absorbed by the body. It is called as digestion. Once again I will repeat the definition of digestion. The process by which food is broken down into a simpler form so that it can be easily taken in or absorbed by the body is called digestion. We have learned this digestion process in 4th standard. Okay. How many of you remember this? Yes, I hope everybody remember this digestion process. Okay. Now, straight from the heart, where do you think the food must be going after you put it in your mouth and swallow it? In the picture given here, draw the path of the food through your body. Now this picture you can see on page number 27 of your textbook. So what you have to do, you have to draw the journey of the food from the mouth till the stomach. So you have to draw a picture where the blank outline is given. And this outline is given on page number 27. So you have to think where do the food must be going after you put it in your mouth and swallow it. So you have to show how the food is traveling in our body. So that you have to draw. Okay. Now here you can see a picture of digestive system. Now many organs work together and form a system. This system helps to digest our food. Now digest is, what is digestion we have seen? Now this is digestive system. Now this digestive system is made up of many organs. We know that cells, tissue, organs, organ system, yes, and organism. So here many organs, they work together and forms digestive system. Now you can see here first is mouth, yes. So we will see how the digestive system works. Now you can see in this picture the different parts of digestive system, that is mouth, esophagus. Esophagus is also called as food pipe. Then it goes to the stomach, then small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. And there are two glands you can see, liver and pancreas, which secretes the digestive juices. Okay. So these are the parts of digestive system. Now we will see how these parts help in digestion. Okay. Now the process of digestion. The process of digestion starts in the mouth itself. Here the food is broken down by biting and chewing. This chewed food mixed with the liquid called saliva, which helps in digestion. Now the process of digestion starts from the mouth itself. When we are chewing the food gets mixed with the saliva and saliva helps to digest some nutrients in the food. Then after that we swallow the food and the food passes through the food pipe or esophagus. So food passes from the mouth through this thin long tube. Esophagus is nothing but a thin long tube, and it reaches the stomach. Through the food pipe, food reaches the stomach. In the stomach, now stomach is a sac-like organ where food is broken down further. The churning of the food takes place in the stomach. Few nutrients are digested in the stomach. Then after the stomach, the food passes to small intestine. Now food from the stomach passes into the small intestine. Here all the useful nutrients are absorbed by the blood and taken to all the parts of the body. So nutrients are absorbed in small intestine. Whatever food we eat, it contains some nutrients. So these nutrients are absorbed by the blood in small intestine. Okay. Then here one gland is there. It is liver. So it produces juices that play an important role in the digestion of food. So liver produces bile juice. So it is helpful for digestion of the food. Then after that, the food passes to large intestine. So it holds the food that cannot be digested, absorbs water from it and forms waste products from it called feces. Now in the large intestine, what happens? Large intestine holds the food that cannot be digested. Once the nutrients are absorbed in the small intestine, the waste material or the waste food is transported to the large intestine. So large intestine holds the food that cannot be digested, and what it does, it absorbs the water which is present in that undigested food. So water from it is absorbed, and the waste which is remaining, it is called as feces. So that feces is sent to the rectum, and then finally the feces are removed from the body through the anus. Understood? So this is the process of digestion. So today we have learned what is digestion, parts of the digestive system and process of digestion. I hope you have understood this, the process of digestion. Even we are going to share a link of a video where you can see the process of digestion, and you will understand it much better. For today, we'll stop here. Have a nice day. Thank you.